Okay, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to talk about completely different thing. and we're going to focus on elegant style. I like to talk about elegant, different elegant styles from time to time. We obviously said about classic, feminine, sexy, flamboyant, as well like a countryside style when it comes to elegance. But there's also a style that we didn't discuss, and that's like a elegant vintage style. And today I would like to talk a little bit more about, go back to the past a little bit, talk about different period of time, like 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s. On the 60s, I think going to stop, because I just feel like 70s, 80s, 90s, those were not super elegant periods of the time. So I just want to focus more on those elegant periods, like 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s. And we're going to as well talk how we can dress today, what kind of occasions we can dress in those kind of different type of styles. Because I feel like any of us who want to be elegant, even if we're dressing at now, we don't even maybe know sometimes, but we are copying those styles from the previous years, because they started in, let's say, 20s. But even we're wearing something today that actually is coming from this period of time, and maybe we don't even know. But I just feel like it's good to educate ourselves, and it's good to look into this kind of vintage styles and those kind of retro styles, because they are very, very feminine. So when 1900 finished, there is start to be this kind of period that ladies from 1900 to 1910, let's say, no, 1913, 14, they still were wearing long dresses. This is still very modest period. And actually on the beginning of 1900, there was this kind of popular trend that women, they were wearing this kind of pigeon-shaped dresses, that the chest were coming forward, the back was going backward, so it was creating this kind of pigeon. And I obviously have a picture here for you to actually see that, because imagine a pigeon. But that's what it is, actually. Pigeons have this kind of shape, you know, which is quite funny. But overall, those were dresses on the beginning of the 19th century. And then 1910, ladies were starting wearing more A-lines. They start looking a little bit more like dresses we could wear actually today. So the fashion was changing, and the fashion of the period of 1900, this is like one of the best period I think we can talk about retro and vintage style, because there's so much change. Every 10 years something has changed, something completely, drastically sometimes change, sometimes just small things change. But overall, the 1900, 20th century period overall is a period of a big change. When it comes to 1920s, which I personally really, really love this period, this Gatsby parties, this kind of style of shine, spark of ladies wearing those kind of beautiful but not very flattering dresses, because those in 1920s, they were on the shape of the barrel. So let's not forget that it didn't really give them a lot of shape, but has this kind of really rich class to it, has this kind of maybe not beautiful hourglass shape. Women look just different from the 90s. Also, when it comes to women's hair, this is completely new trend. Women start wearing this kind of shortcut hair. When it comes to evening, they create this kind of like a stick to your head, this kind of wave style, which is absolutely beautiful, absolutely classic. If you would like to wear something like this today, I don't even know how to do it, but I would love to wear something, a hairstyle like this. I'm not sure if with my longer hair would be possible, but we actually, for our 30 years old, which coming in February for me and for my friend, we planning to do a party in this kind of 20s style. So this is going to be occasion for me to actually do this kind of hairstyle, go to the hairdresser and actually do that. So when I'm going to do it, I'm going to post a video about this as well, because I'm sure some of you might be interesting. And this kind of style of 20s, I just love that, you know, the sparkle, the champagne going on, this kind of like I'm saying, this kind of Gatsby style of the parties that everybody's dancing to this amazing music, you know. I've missed this kind of time when there was parties like this, and now we're obviously trying to recreate that for our birthday, so hopefully it's going to work out. And I wanted to mention that if some of you are interested in 20s and looking, because I sometimes read that ladies a lot of time, they looking for some kind of TV shows or some kind of movies that they are representing some kind of classic styles, then for 20s it's really, really good to watch Miss Fisher. She is this kind of woman detective that she in 20s that she's I don't know, going for some, it's a little bit like Hercules Poirot, that she's going for some kind of, maybe to visit the friends and someone die, and obviously she's going to find out who killed this person or who commit the crime. And Miss Fisher, she has a lot of different outfits, a lot of going on in her wardrobe. So if you're looking for some kind of 20s inspirations, then I would highly recommend to watch Miss Fisher. And I was watching her few times, didn't finish everything because there's few seasons on Netflix, so I think it's still over there. So if you're interested, then check Netflix. Okay, and then after that, we're jumping obviously to 30s. And 30s still, when it comes to women's hair, still have this kind of like close to the head hairline that a little bit maybe longer, but they are waves, they a little bit maybe put a little bit up as well, so create this kind of more volume to the hair. 30s, you can still see and notice this kind of puffy blouses, puffy, even dress with this kind of puffiness to it. A lot of skirts that they are actually going to be longer. So from 20s, when ladies were wearing before knees dresses, so look how a big difference is that. 1910, long dresses, very modest. 1920, you can go a little bit more crazy, shorter dresses. 1930s, again, going to the fashion, this kind of length of your calves, of your ankles, so covering your legs a little bit more again. And also for the evening, evening dresses has changed completely. So that's a drastic change from 1920s to 1930s. Very elegant, long gowns that we would wear today, for example, for some kind of black tie events. Those are starting to getting very popular. Those are wear on the evening. They're low back. Those are as well very sexy, long dresses, very feminine. A lot of them made of velvet, of thicker material, of satin as well, so thinner but more like feminine as well materials. And what is actually coming to 1930s as well, that clothes are starting to getting produced, they are man-made as well, so they are starting to be available to everyone, so it's not only privileged people who can actually dress nicely more. So 1940s were different because there was a Second World War. And what happened when there is a war, there are always some kind of shortages when it comes to materials, there are shortages when it comes to fabric, and people always need to adjust. And the same happened, that's what happened to ladies in this period. They needed to adjust, they were wearing uniforms, they were wearing more the outfits that they were just more suitable for this period of the time, for this difficult period of the time. So they couldn't just wear dresses and go for some kind of galas all the time. This was the period of the war, and listen, maybe you learned something. This was the period of the war, so obviously because of the shortages, the fashion changed for this period. After Second World War, fashion started coming back. And in fact, in 1947, Christian Dior presented his like a new look collection, which completely changed the fashion, And as you can see, you will see those pictures of those of models that presenting those beautiful full skirts, which also created this kind of trend and this kind of look for the 50s. So this is quite a big thing in the fashion industry when this new look of Christian Dior happened. And the skirts, not only that they became this kind of full and longer, they became more feminine on the end of the 40s. And as I was saying, this created this kind of after looks for the 50s as well. And 50s actually continued those kind of very full skirts. They were also added, they were also start popular, those kind of very feminine pencil skirts, which is kind of, I feel like 50s are very, very retro. When we actually talk about vintage, a lot of people think about 50s, 60s, because they created this kind of big femininity when it comes to woman fashion. And they are absolutely gorgeous, absolutely beautiful. And if you want to wear something from like a vintage style, I think 50s and 60s is going to be for you like a more, they can be more like an everyday fashion. And obviously those kind of 20s, 30s, they're going to be more like a parties that you would just create a look for them. You wouldn't really dress so much fashion of 20s every day, but you can dress everyday fashion from 50s and 60s, because they're such a beautiful circle dresses. They are beautiful pants, longer pencil skirts, which are very sexy and very feminine. And those you could actually wear today as well. When we think about 50s icons, you can think about one of my favorite, Audrey Hepburn. You can think about... Masz tutaj, kochani, masz. No, masz, popatrz się. You can think about Grace Kelly. You can think about Bridget Bardot. So obviously Marilyn Monroe as well. So those are those kind of famous as well icons that we know more about than if we would actually think about icons from 30s. 50s have as well those kind of beautiful, beautiful style. And as I'm saying, they're very, very feminine. When it comes to 60s, women have this kind of like a more, this was a period of innovation for women, because women start wearing jeans much more often. And also there was this kind of famous capri pants. Casual dresses became more popular. So this kind of 60s start, this kind of more casual as well garments being acceptable when we actually dressing outside. And I think this kind of casual starts from there then, and I think it's coming till even our now period today, because today basically everything is acceptable. Whatever we want to dress, we can go outside, and nothing is going to really surprise anyone. Very popular when it comes to this elegant fashion became those kind of outfits from Breakfast at Tiffany's, because this was 61st actually when the video was released. And I think very, very like a famous fashion icon from 60s is actually Jackie Kennedy, with her, all her pastel dresses, pastel jackets, all those kind of very, very, she represents this kind of very, very classic woman and classic outfits. And another very, I would say famous 60s icon is Ursula Anders. And she, I don't know if you remember, but she was first James Bond girl. She has this kind of famous look when she's coming from the sea in this kind of white bikini with the knife, and she was like snorkeling for the mussels. Ladies and gentlemen, I need to finish this video. I was planning to do it until 60s anyway, because I feel like 70s are getting really like very colorful, very like crazy, and I don't feel this is very elegant period. And 80s, 90s, we all know what was happening in 90s and 80s, and you know, I just feel like it's better to think first about those retro and vintage you know, period, and if something, we can always come back to this 80s 70s 80s 90s, if you wish to watch that as well. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave it a thumbs up, and I hope to see you in a couple of days.